Hello, and thanks for tuning in. If you're new to the channel, please hit the subscribe button. If you're returning, thanks. It means a lot. Okay, in this video, we're going to get into datalogging the OBD1 Honda computer. If you haven't already checked out the previous videos, click the link above and please do. They will bring you back to a playlist and you can look at all these videos before you get to this point and start messing with parameters and looking at parameters. So now you're at the point where we've burned the bin file to the SST chip. You got the SST chip in your hand, and you go and drop it in your ECU, and you're ready to start your car. So you start your car, and now you want to view the data and see exactly what's coming on and what's happening in the engine. So before you do any of that, you want to start the car. You want to get the car totally warmed up, everything idling fine, all your temperatures right, because you're going to be in a different status with your O2 monitors and all that. If the engine's cold, you're going to be dumping more fuel in. You want everything to be right around operating temperature before you start making any changes. So the most important thing to do now is what FTDI controller are you going to use? So you have several options. They have an FTDI controller that runs in with a USB cable, which is the cheapest, easiest way. It's the way that I'm using on this video. There's a Bluetooth module that you can use, and that most of your emulators have a way to tap into the CN2 port. And the CN2 port is needed for data logging, except on some of the emulators, it might come integrated with it. So the first thing you have to do is find out what COM port your emulator or your FTDI controller is gonna be on. So this one's on COM port 7 on my computer, FTDI. So keep that in mind. We're gonna go over to File, Settings, and we're going to look here at data logging, and you see HTS has already got it set to COM port 7 on my computer. But let's say you're on a different COM port. You can open this up, and if you had different COM ports or had it plugged in somewhere else, you could manually change the COM port. But for the most part, the smart port scan works fine. So we know we're on COM port 7. We're just going to go up to data log, and we're going to start data logging. Now you see all these items populated up here. So I have my simulator set up to basic idle conditions. We're sitting at idle right now, 764 RPM, perfect stoichiometric 14.7. That's for NA engine. Intake air temps are 88. That's a little high, so I'll bring that down. And, you know, this is just for viewing purposes right now. As you can see, I'm changing the air intake temperature sensor. And we'll set it at about 74. And I'll bring you through the RPMs and everything. And this is kind of what you're going to see when you're data logging. So you're going to be seeing right around your idle point, it's going to be jumping like that, kind of up and down, left and right, trying to find its happy spot. And your O2 sensor will be doing the same thing. It'll be going like that. And this is where you get into where you're going to be tuning and adding and taking away fuel, and that'll be a total different video because there's so much going on when you have to do that. But basically, as you're data logging, this is what you're gonna see. You're gonna see your RPMs moving, you're gonna see your O2 sensor reading, and this is on the narrow band right now. So you'll see that moving. You gotta have a wide band though. Absolutely have to have a wide band hooked up to it to figure out what's going on. There's just not enough voltage or data coming out of a narrow band. There's many different ways that people hook up the O2 sensor on the Y band. I use D14, A26, and A25, and I go in through the ECU side. There's tons of other people that use tons of other ways that work. Find the way that works the best for you. That's all I can advise you on. So as you're sitting here watching it, it's just going to show you all your parameters, your RPMs, your air intake, your coolant temperature, your ignition, your injector status, and you can add more tables up here. So you add data, new, and you can go in there and change everything. But what I like to do is once I have the engine warmed up and data logging, go to my parameters and I set my idle settings. And I start to look at, you know, what's going on in all these categories and all these parameters here. And depending on how your engine's running, set your idle to where it's happy, to where it's not feeling like it's stalling or bogging or over revving, because if your idle set too high, you're going to burn fuel. If it's set too low, you're going to have no power off the start line. So find that sweet spot with your idle, get that set up, and then start reading all your data. And like I said, we'll go into another tuning video on that. But that's basically how you set it up. It's pretty easy. If you guys want to see how to set up a Bluetooth module, drop a comment below and I'll make a video on that if there's enough interest. But simple, easy. You know, the software will detect most of it on your newer computers. If you've got an older computer, like I said, you run into an issue, you can try and manually set it up and come in here and change the COM ports and all that stuff. But that's really it. That's the simple, easy, nitty-gritty way to hook it up. And I'll show you guys. It does pick up everything. You find my RPM setting here. I'm going to bring it into VTEC. And let's see. One second. All right, there we go. So you see the fuel pump's on here. It's running, and we're going to run up the RPMs, and a stock P28 is set at about 5,500, so we're at 5,450. We're still in the low cams here, and you see the four dots there, and we'll bump it up into the high cam, and there we are, right at around 5,500 it crosses over. And as you see, the map changes. And now you're in the high cam map for your VTEC. And this is all VTEC here. So as you get into more tuning, you'll start smoothing this stuff out. And like I said, these will be later videos. This is how you data log. This is how you view the data. Another thing you can do down here is live graphing. Enable live graphing. And now you see at the bottom here, it's going to pick up all these parameters and record it. RPM, TPMS, I'm sorry, TPS, air intake temp, and engine coolant temp. So I'm going to change the air intake temp to show you guys a spike. And we're looking at the blue one. And you see, I'm sorry, not the blue one, the orange one. You see as it's recording, I'm changing that data. And now let's change the RPM as well. As you can see. And this is what would be recording on your live stream here. And then you would use this. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. You would use this data here to basically make your corrections in your table. If you're driving on the road, under what load and everything, you can record it. So let's go start recording. So now we're recording. What's going on with the engine? This is all recording. And then we'll go back and we'll stop recording. So all that was recorded into a, basically into a file. These are your live plots, a little bit easier to read. And we'll change the O2 sensor here. Where are we? And as you see, it's just a little bit easier to read your O2 on this. So you can find that perfect air fuel ratio that you're looking for. Also here you can edit your graph. You can add five values, different colors, and you have all your map sensor boost, everything. You know, it's tailor suited to what you want to see. And basically that's really it. And you'll save your data logging file. Save in new data logging format. You want to do that in case there's anybody that wants to do any remote tuning. You need to save it like this, or if HTS developers need to see it, just save it in the data logger format. And you would save your data logger. And then save. Now you can go back and open it. Open log. And you see here, it shows you what's going on. So you can go ahead and make your changes. And you see how it actually recorded what was going on. And this is just like a playback. So on your map here, you can go now and just make your little changes, what you need to do. And like I said, this will be in a different video, how to actually read all this. But I hope this basic nitty-gritty video helps on getting your data logging hooked up. Like always, I read all the comments, drop any ideas below, good or bad. I read all of them, I respond to all of you, and I really appreciate the support. So to the next video, thanks for watching. Please subscribe.